Hey guys, today I wanted to talk about why meal timing, and in particular talking about why protein timing actually does matter for body composition, and building muscle and all that good stuff that we all want to do when we are interested in improving our fitness and body composition and strength. So essentially, we have two processes that occur in our body. We have muscle protein synthesis and muscle protein breakdown. So basically, they occur in a cyclic pattern throughout the day. We like to think of, like, some people think of, oh, I'm building muscle, and all of a sudden, oh, I'm not losing, I'm like losing. The reality is that you're not always building muscle and you're not always losing muscle. You're always going to have periods of net protein gain, like net positive protein balance, and periods of protein breakdown. A good example of this is, when you're actually resistance training, you are breaking down muscle. You're in a catabolic state where you are breaking down, your muscles. It is only when you actually do recover and provide sufficient protein, rest, you're in an anabolic state where you are actually building muscle. And it's the relative rates of muscle protein breakdown and muscle protein synthesis that facilitates a, whether or not you build muscle, or you don't build muscle, or you lose muscle, in worst case scenario. So muscle protein synthesis is just think of it as the process of building muscle, of actually, recovering. It is stimulated by muscle contraction, resistance exercise, so weight training, insulin, testosterone, growth hormone, essential amino acids, in particular leucine, which is the most important part of, and when we actually do classify protein quality, you're talking about leucine in particular. Because like Lane Norton is, he did a, is the, he did like the premier study on why we have leucine threshold per meal to actually maximally stimulate muscle protein synthesis. And in addition, adequate caloric intake is important for muscle protein synthesis. The reason why that's important is because when we're in a deficit, this becomes of really like super, super, super important if you want to actually maintain as much muscle as possible. Because a lot of people like to say that nutrient timing doesn't really matter and it's all the stuff at the end of the day that counts. And like that is true for the bulk of it. The bulk of like your caloric, what you are eating in terms of calories and then protein is what mostly matters. But it's saying that it doesn't matter at all is just simply, incorrect. Muscle protein breakdown can occur. It's stimulated by prolonged exercise. Actually, when beginning a new exercise program, if you're in a detrained state because so much damage is occurring, you can't really recover from it adequately. Hormones like glucagon, which breaks down amino acids into your bloodstream to supply energy, cortisol, and like other inflammatory factors, as well as a calorie deficit. But basically, I have this chart right here, kind of detailing what this looks like. So this dotted line is going to be a muscle protein breakdown. Okay, so again, the process of not building muscles essentially. Remember how I said that first off in the video, it occurs in waves, it's not like an on or off switch. This is kind of what it looks like. So, if in a normal sedentary conditions, if you're not engaging in resistance exercise, this is what it looks like. And muscle protein breakdown will roughly equal muscle protein synthesis. However, if you do have resistance training, you're on special sports supplements like anabolic steroids, you will have an actually a higher peak of muscle protein synthesis relative to muscle protein breakdown. So basically, your body becomes even more receptive to those nutrients that you are intaking, and you have increased muscle protein synthesis in those states as long as you're providing enough protein, enough calories. And so that's just kind of like a visual representation of what it looks like. They've done a few studies. I will reference it on the screen, specifically with one I'm referring to. But they basically found that muscle pork protein synthesis, the optimal meal distribution, was 4 to 5 meals a day of 0.25 to 0.3 grams per kilogram of body weight throughout those meals, which goes basically roughly translates to around 15 to 25 grams of protein per meal equally spaced throughout the day in 4 to 5 feedings for most individuals. Is optimal for promoting maximal muscle protein synthesis throughout the day. So in the practical application of this, I guess, and the reason why I'm making this video is just to help you guys with constructing your dietary plan, your nutrition plan, and just understanding that if you want to maximize muscle gain, maximize muscle retention, you want to maximize any sort of body composition outcome, this is something that you do need to pay attention to. So if you guys are not doing so already, I would recommend trying to have 4 or 5 meals a day as equally spread out as possible with, at least 0.25 to 0.3 grams per kilogram of body weight per meal worth of protein, just in order to maximize performance outcomes and body composition outcomes. So that's my recommendation. Hopefully this video helped. Nutrient timing does matter. Again, it is not the end all be all, but if you are trying to maximize performance and recovery outcomes, because I know that from personal experience, when I really pay attention to this, I can recover from like slightly higher volumes of training. I feel better. I can have enhanced recovery in between sessions. And this, really does matter, especially once you start to get more advanced and you're trying to really milk as much, strength gains as possible, by facilitating higher levels of recovery, higher levels of protein, muscle protein synthesis, and increasing your overall, body composition outcomes, losing less muscle in a deficit, retaining as much muscle as possible, building as much muscle, etc. So hopefully this video was helpful to you guys. I haven't really recorded anything for training just because I've been my D-load week, so it's pretty boring. But I'll be starting a new meso cycle on Monday, and then I will probably do a little more training stuff then. But hopefully this video was helpful. If you guys did like it, please like, share, and subscribe. And until the next one, I'll see you guys later. Bye.